Hello friends, myself Prakash Khude, Assistant Professor in ML Textile Engineering College. In last video, we are talking about the drying process. As you know that drying and heat setting are most vital post-spinning process of your filament when you want to form. So in this part, we'll discuss about the heat setting process. So as you know that heat setting is most important post-spinning process. The heat setting has been carried out to bring the material to the thermal equilibrium stage at particular temperature of use. So at thermal equilibrium, the material would not be change its morphology even if it has been kept longer for that same temperature. So that is the main advantage of heat setting process. In this case, we ultimately bringing this material to its thermal equilibrium stage. So there is one terminology, another is there, that is your degree of set. So this term is often described the extent of heat setting process. So that will ultimately measures how close the material has been moved to its thermal equilibrium position. And 100% set material is considered to be at thermal equilibrium at given temperature. So you'll see what are the different types of heat settings are there. One is your normal, you can say that temporary heat setting process, where this type of setting has been destroyed with the regular use of material. Like if you are ironing your cloth or if you are steam pressing your cloths, so that whatever the setting has been done, that has been destroyed over the period of use. So that is not the permanent one. So the second one is your semi-permanent heat setting. So in this type of setting, the material is raised above its TG, that is glass transition temperature, and then it has set to into the new form. So in this type of set has been maintained with the normal use of material. However, the setting has been lost when material has been subjected to the serve condition of use. So this is in this case, normally we need to raise your temperature, that material need to be taken to the above TG, and they will set into the another form, and it has the much more like stability as compared to your temporary heat set material. And the next one, if you see here, there is a permanent heat set. So in this type of setting, this involves the changing its internal morphology of your material in such a way that it would not reverse till the material has been destroyed by its above melting point. So in this case, we are ultimately changing the internal morphology of your material, and there is a not reversal of your material has been taken place until it has been destroyed completely above its melting point. So we have seen these three basic types of your heat setting, that is your temporary, where like I have given the example as steam press cotton fabric. If you talk about the semi-permanent heat setting, in this case material has been raised to this TG. For example, you have this hot washing or steaming of your material above is TG. And the permanent heat setting, where we are ultimately changing the internal structure of your morphology of your material. The next part we'll discuss what are the different parameters that will affect the heat setting process. These are the four parameters we can see here, five parameters. One is your temperature of heat setting. Second is the time, how much time we are giving for the heat setting. And third, if the material has been tensioned, what is the how much amount of tension has been given to the material during your heat setting. Fourth one is your moisture in the starting material and its sensitivity to its heat. In last video also, we talk about the temperature of your drying also, drying temperature. Similar case has been there if you are having the temperature of heat setting and the morphology of your starting material, that is the last point in case of your parameters. We'll see how all these parameters will affect your heat setting performance. The first one is your temperature of heat setting. So as you know that the heat setting involves the formation of new crystallize in the amorphous part of your fiber. So due to this crystal formation, this is a general thermal process and it will maximizes at certain temperature. So this crystallization ultimately involves the nucleation followed by your growth of nucleated crystallites, and this nucleation is facilitated at low temperature. While this growth has been facilitated at higher temperature, if you see, this nucleation has been facilitated at low temperature while the growth has been facilitated at higher temperature. So if you see the crystallization involves this both the phase, that first is your nucleation that has been followed by your growth of nucleated crystallized. And this rate of crystallization is also depend upon the orientation of your fiber which has been being crystallized. At higher orientation, if you see, the rate of crystallization may significantly higher than the lesser oriented material. If you talk about the highly oriented yarn or lowly oriented yarn, in highly oriented yarn, the rate of crystallization is significantly higher as compared to the low oriented yarn. Therefore, this drawn yarn may undergoes the heat setting through the crystallization in fraction of time than otherwise it needed for your undrawn yarn. That is a basic fundamental of if you want to use this heat setting. If you are need to have this, the temperature has been much more important case. The next, if you see here, I discuss about this temperature units. At higher temperature, the orientation change tends to relax much more faster, and the fiber can lose its orientation if left at that temperature for sufficiently long time. So if you are having this much more temperature, the whatever the polymeric chains are there, they will try to relax much more faster, and due to that, there is a fiber can lose their orientation if it has been left at that temperature for sufficient longer period of your time. Therefore, there is a competition between your relaxation of your polymeric chains, and that will result in your shrinkage of your fiber and the locking of your structure due to the formation of crystallized. So this is the two parameters we need to much more taken into the consideration. That is the relaxation of polymeric chains that will ultimately result in your shrinkage of fiber, and second is your locking of your structure due to the formation of these crystals. So therefore, the selection of this appropriate temperature of heat setting is very much important, so that thermal equilibrium may be reached without significantly losing the orientation. So that is the main case we need to, if you want to take this temperature of heat setting, that should be taken care of, that so that the thermal stability should be, equilibrium has been reached without losing its orientation. Next point is your time of heat setting. In earlier slide, we had discussed about that the rate of crystallization is ultimately depend upon your temperature of heat setting and the orientation of your drawn yarn. Also, this disorientation is also the function of your time. Keeping in this view of these two, the time is deciding factor that the thermal equilibrium has been reached in minimum time without loss of orientation. So time is one of the deciding factor, so that the thermal equilibrium that need to be reached within minimum time and at the same time without loss of your orientation, or you can say that minimum loss of your orientation, the thermal equilibrium should be reached in minimum amount of time. The next part is how much tension has been given to the material during your heat setting. So as we know that the material can be subjected in loose form or without any tension, or that can be under highly tension form. So in free form, that is we called as a loosely form, the chains can disoriented at faster rate because we are not applying any tension in this case, and they will try to form these laminar crystals. Here you can see this laminar crystals has been formed. This is the free annealing we normally call as. Here polymeric chains has not oriented in the direction of your fiber, and they will try to form the laminar structures at the heat setting temperature, and that will result in the higher shrinkage of your fiber and lower connectivity among this polymeric chains. So here you can see this is your free annealing without any tension, and the second part is your taut annealing. That is means that it has been stretched under tension. Though the yarn has reached their thermal equilibrium easily, it loses its all mechanical properties because the connectivity between this network of your polymeric chains is very poor, and the fiber are unable to elongate and they will bear this load. So this network of polymeric chains, the connectivity between polymeric chains is one of the parameters, important parameters, so that the fiber should bear that whatever the amount of stress or elongation we are applying or that load. The next point, if you see, that is your moisture in the starting material. In last lecture also we have seen that how the moisture in the starting material that will affect your drawing performance. Similar case here, it will also affect your heat setting performance. As we know that the nylon is very sensitive to the moisture, as the nylon having the moisture retention percentage 4%, and their TG becomes lower as the moisture content has been increases. Since this moisture has been ultimately acting as a plasticizer, so their chains may relax and they will try to fold easily when in case of wet state compared to the dry state. In this case, there are two states has been discussed. One, if you are doing this heat setting at dry state, and in case of wet state. The for example, in drawn nylon 6, the dye uptake and the diffusion coefficient are generally increased when heat setting has been carried out by steam, or in case of diffusion, the wet state. In case of nylon 6, this dye uptake and the diffusion coefficient has been increased when this heat setting has been carried out by steam. Similar case, this tendency will increase with the temperature of heat setting temperature. However, this dry heat setting up to 160 degrees Celsius gives the reverse tendency. In case of dry state heat setting, it will give the reverse. Like in case of steam, the dye uptake and diffusion coefficient has been improved in case of nylon. While if you see this same case in case of dry state, it has been reverse tendency. With this steam, the chains will fold to grow into the larger crystals, and molecular packing of your amorphous region loses as a result of inclusion of your water. On other hand, in dry setting, the increase in the crystallinity and also the closeness of packing in the amorphous regions results in the poor diability. If you are increasing your dry heat setting, if you are doing the increasing crystallinity and also the closeness of your packing of amorphous region results in the poor diability and diffusion coefficient of your heat set material. Interestingly, in the both types of this heat setting treatment, the diffusion coefficient decreases with increasing the tension of your sample during the heat setting. Next part is the morphology of your starting material. How this morphology of starting material has a significant effect on your heat setting process. If material is already crystalline, it may undergo the setting to retain the deformed state. Therefore, material have the tendency to crystalline during the spinning or during the storage, such as nylon and polypropylene are difficult to the heat set. So in this case, we can say that if you want to make this improve your heat setting performance, there could be chances that how the material has undergoes this heat setting performance. So in such material, the imperfect crystallize such as pseudo hexagon alpha phase in nylon 6 or symmetric crystals in the polypropylene may undergoes the transformation into the perfect monoclinic alpha phase on the heat setting. However, the gamma phase of your nylon 6 that induces the higher speed of nylon 6 that has been found to be extremely stable at that heat and doesn't convert into the alpha phase even at higher temperature of annealing. So we can see here, if the nylon 6 has been there in alpha gamma phase and it has been doing during your high speed spinning, it will be much more stable to the heat as compared to your alpha phase, and it doesn't convert it into the alpha phase even at higher temperature of your heat setting performance, that is annealing your heat setting performance. So thank you so much, students, and in the next video we'll try to discuss about the spinning of your POI and FDY. So till that, subscribe to my channel Textile Gyan and like, share and comment. Thank you so much. Stay tuned.